about the connection between Hajj and Eid al-Adha and also the life lessons from this topic.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, we are just enjoying the show very much. Alhamdulillah. Nearly we are on the end of the show. Alhamdulillah. So this season is all about Hajj and Eid al-Adha. These 10 special days are very, very special, right? So in these days, we go for Hajj. We do, we celebrate the Eid. So we just want to remind for ourselves, what is the connection in between these two? These 10 days, Hajj and Eid al-Adha. Okay, first of all, we have to understand what is Hajj, right? So Hajj is one of the main pillars of Islam. One of the pillars of Islam. Like if you are a Muslim, then we have to do Hajj. Like if you are capable of doing so, then we have to do. Nearly 2 million people go for Hajj, for this pilgrimage every year. This amount even increases, subhanAllah. Nothing decreases. So it's just increase in numbers every year. Like it's a completely chance, like it's a one-time opportunity to wipe off all our sins. And the people who are returning from Hajj, they are just like a newborn babies, subhanAllah, without any sin on them. And subhanAllah, when a Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded a prophet to build a Kaaba, you all know that, right? Who is a prophet? Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam build the Kaaba. Okay, and after building the Kaaba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered a prophet to call the people for Hajj. And this is said in the Surah 22:27, okay? And Allah says the people, Allah is commanding Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam to call the people for Hajj. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam is asking Allah, Ya Allah, how can I call the people for it when my voice won't reach everyone? Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is asking, this is a valid question, right? How can I call every Muslim to come for Hajj while no one could hear me? So Allah is saying, you convey, you do it, you call, we will convey it. So he, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, stood on a mountain, okay? He stood on a mountain and he said, oh people, Allah has prescribed Hajj upon us, so perform Hajj. Subhanallah, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam is calling the people. So by hearing, it is said that the mountains, it lowered themselves so that the voice can reach all parts of the earth. You know, everyone, subhanallah, just imagine this thing. That day before many, many, many years, Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam stood on the mountain and said, oh people, come for Hajj. And just today, imagine what is happening right now. And until the day of judgment, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, the Hajj will perform each and every year. What we say, labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Oh ya Allah, we responded to the call. The Hajj, the Hajis who go for the Hajj and Umrah, what they say? Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Labbaik la sharika laka labbaik. Innal hamda. وَالنِّعْمَةَ لَكَ وَالْمُلْكُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَا. So what does it mean? That day our Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he stood on the mountain.
Is it said?
Today we are responding the calls. Today we are saying, Ya Allah, I am responding to your call. I am coming to your house. Subhanallah, this is amazing, right? So this is all started. Subhanallah, we have to think about the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This doesn't happen anything like that. Okay, just imagine all the rituals of Hajj. All the rituals of Hajj. How do we do that? How do we do that? All the rituals of Hajj. We remember the sacrifice of our Hajar alayhi salam, the wife of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Right? We go to Safa Marwa. Like she ran for the water. We do tawaf around the Kaaba, like a Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he built that first Kaaba, right? Like everything is connected with Ibrahim alayhi salam story. We remember till now his sacrifice, his great sacrifice, a Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Okay, what is a life lesson we can take from this Hajj? There are so similar, like subhanAllah, this is very, very important. And why is this Hajj is connected to our pillars of Islam? Why? A great question. Why? To go to the barren land, to do all these rituals. Why is this pillar of Islam? There is a bigger connection to our lives. What is the connection? Because there is a surah in the Quran called as Surah Hajj, okay? On this surah, first Allah talks about the day of judgment. Allah does not talk about Hajj, but rather He talks about the day of judgment. So the day of judgment and the Hajj is connected. It is linked between together. How come it is connected? How come there is a big connection? First, see. First, who called for Hajj? Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. He stood on the mountain and called for Hajj. And now we are responding to the Hajj, and every year the people are going for the Hajj, right? So the second connection, on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to blow the sur. Okay? The trumpet will be blown on the day of judgment, and all the people will come towards Allah. That call will be responded. Okay? Isn't it connected, right? This is connected, right? Second thing, the people who go for Hajj, they say, like, they call their friends and families. They say that, Assalamu Alaikum, I'm going to the Hajj. Please make dua for me. I don't know whether I will come back or not. Please take care of my children. Please take care of my properties. And all those things they say. Why? Because they don't know. They are not sure that they will come back. Like, they are doing the will and they ask for forgiveness, everyone. The same thing happens on the day of judgment. The farewell meeting is happening there. Right? Just imagine, lots and lots of people gathered in one place. We don't know what is going to happen. We don't know the Jannah or Jahannam is going to be given for them. SubhanAllah. And the next thing is the dress of a Haji. The ihram which he wears, he or she. Just imagine, what clothes do they wear for the Hajj? Just two pieces of clothes. Just two pieces of clothes, just white clothes. This reminds us, when we die, this same cloth will be put for us when we die. These same clothes, no perfumes, no fancy clothes, no fancy shoes, no costly things, no costly watches, everything whatsoever. Now this, in this world, this in this dunya, the people, they just drive crazy for the branded things. For example, branded perfumes, branded watches, branded this, branded that. When you go for Hajj, do you do all these things? Never. We just wear these two pieces of ihram. This reminds us our death on the day of judgment. They don't, even though they have millions of monies in their hand, but this, you know, that is not needed for their ihram. That is not needed at all. This is a greater connection between the ihram which we owe for the Hajj, and the shroud and the coffin which it will be owned for us. These are two very similar things. Two pieces of clothes only, right? Reminds of the day of judgment, reminds of our death, reminds of our grave. SubhanAllah. And the next connection is the crowds of Hajj. Just imagine 2 million people gathering in one place, going in the same direction. On the day of judgment, all the people will be gathered on the mahshar. SubhanAllah. This reminds on the day of judgment. This is a reminder for the day of judgment. The second thing is the pilgrimage are all in the same direction, even though they're from different parts of the world. They might be from Africa, Australia, America, India, Dubai, Saudi, everywhere. They might be coming from every place, but they all are in the same direction. They're going together to Arafah, to Mina, to Muzdalifah, to Jamarat, doing the Tawaf. on the day, on the Muzdalifah, there is the people, they have to, you know, just imagine the biggest and richest of the people also go for the Hajj. And even the poor of the poorest people also go for the Hajj. You know what happens? Every people have to sleep on the same ground, have to sleep on the open ground, open sky, on the mud and stones. Just imagine, where are the money? Where is the fame? Where is the everything you have in this dunya right now? You left everything and you came here. Where is everything? You forgot? Now there is nothing for you. Just empty land. Just you are just sleeping on the empty ground. This reminds us a day of judgment. Even though we have lots of money, it is not going to help us. Even though in this dunya you might have lots of money, on the Muzdalifah you can't afford a fancy beds and fancy rooms for you. You have to sleep there. A king and the poor people will be together. So this is the reality of life. This reminds us day of judgment. And also it reminds... Okay. And this reminds us on the grave, every people has to go on the same grave. That is, there is no high quality grave, low quality grave, rich people grave, low people grave, nothing, never. Subhanallah. Everyone has to go on the same grave. This reminds us, this Muzdalifah, the one day on Hajj reminds us that day on the grave, where we'll be all alone. There is nothing fancy things, even though whatsoever, what's of lots of money we have, nothing is going to help us. So this reminds us, subhanallah. And one more important thing here is, these are the life lessons which we get from Hajj. And what lesson we get from Eid al-Adha? That is the sacrifice day which our Prophet, beloved Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, without no rejection, he accepted the call of his Rabb. He immediately wanted to slaughter his son. For that, what Allah has given honor, just imagine. Till today, until the world ends, everyone is going to celebrate Eid al-Adha, remembering our Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam sacrifice. So the same way, in this life, we have many, many problems and we sacrifice many things for sake of Allah. And one thing, just remember, if we do those sacrifices for the sake of Allah, Allah will surely make you like, subhanAllah, He will give you the honor.